All right, I am with Dane, the director of marketing with Block Lords. Give us a quick TLDR. What is Block Lords? What type of game and what kind of gameplay can users like expect?
Cool. Well, I mean, the vision of the creator founder, being a real gamer, was to design a game that was built off the best of something like Age of Empires, the farming, you know, building a community, and then Crusader Kings, which ultimately was just like political warfare, the psychology, and the kind of manipulation,
right,
tactics. And then, you know, Crusader Kings, which is, you know, epic battle scenes.
Yeah.
So combining those three core components, building it into like a Game of Thrones script narrative, and building it onto blockchain.
Absolutely.
And yeah, I mean, like for us, blockchain is, you know, secondary. First and foremost, we want to create a fun experience, an enjoyable, rich experience using technologies like the internet.
Correct.
For one. And then, you know, everything else that blockchain allows us to use. So,
That's like the best answer you can hear from a team or a dev or any builders, at the fact that they're emphasizing gameplay first, because if you're emphasizing the economy and the blockchain part first, it usually is flawed, because the game has to be fun, it has to be playable, it has to be enjoyable, it has to click, like those experiences that you're talking about. What's been the feedback as a Web3 game here at GDC, a Web2 conference?
Yeah.
So is there pushback? What's the feedback y'all are getting? I'm sure the interest has been heavy.
Surprisingly, we've been very, very welcomed. I think, you know, people kind of come to us for the franchise. So there's like, there's more of a, call it like a film.
You'll have a lore. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you can see us, it's a movie poster. Yeah. So we're treating this as a franchise, and we're not treating it as a Web3 game.
Yeah.
This is just the best fun you can have.
Right.
In a shared universe, call it the metaverse or whatever you'd like.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, people have come over and not actually realize that it's a Web3
game.
Yeah. And then when you tell them it's a blockchain game, they're like, awesome.
Yes, exactly.
Because I think the thing that makes it unique is like our NFTs, you know, what we like to call euro assets, are, you know, actually kind of a real case, an example of using a digital asset in a way in which you as the owner can define the value of the asset, because you play with your euro character,
right?
And you know, you can rise in the ranking, and that's up to you based on your skills, based
your
on
grind, your
exactly,
progression,
based,
exactly.
So you define the value. It's not up to your marketplace to define the value. You
I love
do
it.
That.
You know? I love it.
And long term, I mean, what we see this being is like, we want to see it as like a TV series or an episodic like series where, you know, once the narrative has evolved with gameplay and players kind of defining those characters,
right,
they play their hero in the TV series.
Got it. Okay.
So they the actual stars.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
You know,
and not actors. They define kind of their celebrity status.
Right. And so, last question: where do you see the whole space going? Right. So, like, Web3 gaming, NFTs. Is this the next internet? Like, you know, that Gary Vee says. I'm of the opinion that it definitely has that potential. Where do you see the space going?
I was around for the, you know, Web2 wave and rise. And it's funny how you kind of see the similarities and, you know, the tension and the kind of like the
pushback.
The pushback that we're getting right now.
Yeah.
That was there during the .com era.
Exactly.
You know, like in 4 or 5 years' time, we're going to laugh about it because it was like, well, you know, remember when we used to say NFT, crypto, scam and da-da-da. So, yeah, I mean, it's kind of like, you know, it's just a matter of time.
Agreed.
And I think it's happening, you know, and it's exciting to be part of it.
And I like to use this term. We're not playing with a rock. We're shaping clay here.
Exactly.
We're literally shaping this industry from the ground up.
Exactly that. That's a really, really cool way. I mean, you know, that's probably the best way I've heard it explained. So yeah, that's exactly
pleasure
right.
Pleasure joining me, man.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. All right, what's going on, guys? I'm with Scott, the CMO of Phantasma. Scott, tell us a little bit about Phantasma Chain for those who don't know about your project.
Phantasma is a layer one blockchain built for gamers by gamers. You know, some of our pride is smart NFTs that just allow for the, you know, programmability aspect of that. The in-game assets can move up and an interoperable blockchain. So.
And what's the biggest thing that you picked up being at GDC? Because obviously it's not a blockchain conference, and as we've seen with a lot of like big AAA studios in the past, they've tried to roll out NFT gaming in the thought process, and they've really gotten backlash. What has been the reception you've received from traditional gamers and people coming up that are interested in the smart NFTs and what you guys are doing at Fantasma?
Wow, I didn't even know where to handle that one. I just got into a conversation with a professor from a university down in Miami, and we're in a conversation about, you know, going to speak to some of his students. And, you know, to me, that was pretty awesome because as a professor, he's teaching, you know, the youth, and, you know, he's open-minded about that. But on the flip side of that, you know, before we came, we did our research, and yep. We looked, 87% of people that are a part of here that were interviewed thought that NFTs were, you know, the devil to the gaming world, and humbled because that's behind their computers and whatnot.
Yes.
And people that are here, you know, this industry was a joke 20 years ago.
Right.
Right? And now it's blown up. These people are putting money and effort to see what the future is, and they've been very, very open.
Agreed.
And welcoming.
The amount of literally in-tune listening I've noticed is like when you're actually captivating someone, it's literally as simple as asking, have you played Fortnite? Yes. Have you ever bought a skin? Yes. To resonate with
right.
the gamer, right? They own it. And then they're always, like I've noticed, that just captivates their interest immediately because they get it, right? And then where do you see this going from here? We're at a game developer conference where honestly the biggest buzz around the space is, I think, the Web3 projects, you know? Other than like the Unity booth where everyone's looking for developers for their games, for example.
Right.
Web3's kind of been the talk of the show, in my opinion. Where do you see things going from here?
In terms of the industry itself, I mean, we've put everything we have into this. We believe into this technology. I believe that this technology is going to affect all facets of our lives within, you know, a decade. Today, this is just the beginning of an industry
right.
being disrupted. You know, we're just starting to see that disruption. And, you know, based off of the lineups, I've been doing conferences for 20 years. And I was joking because I have a new metric in conference, and I hit my ATH in terms of lead generation in a day, right?
The ATH, he says.
It's been
the D-gen terms.
It's been great.
Yeah.
And so what is next year gonna look like? If there was six or seven of us and 500 vendors here,
right.
What, 50 blockchain vendors maybe next year?
Yeah, exactly.
And that's, you know, that's the number I'll stick with. I think we're gonna get a 10x in terms of organizations at this type of event, this industry, is the beginning of being disrupted, and I've seen it.
100% agree, and one thing that's really awesome is there's multiple blockchains here.
There are.
Specifically blockchains.
Yeah.
One thing I actually don't see are like Web3 games themselves here. So I think in the next few years, you'll actually start seeing those games coming in to actually showcase their products and the betas and the alpha tests here, and actually you'll create hype like an E3, basically, you know? So to speak, with these conferences. So Scott, I appreciate you joining for just a quick interview.
Yeah.
Pleasure.
Likewise.
From Immutable X. Matt, tell us a little bit about IMX for those who might not know exactly what Immutable does.
Yeah, Immutable X is a layer 2 scaling solution for NFTs on Ethereum. We're really focused on gaming, and we offer gas-free transactions, really high transaction speed, and a really great gaming economy.
Absolutely. And what is the feedback you've gotten here? So, like, I know we're at a Web2 gaming conference, but if you look around, there's so many blockchain projects, which is so bullish for the space. Where do you, like, what is the feedback that you've seen from the people asking about the NFTs integrating into the games and the blockchain? What have you heard?
Yeah, it's really exciting, right? So we're expecting some Web3 native games to come in and talk to us. We've really had a lot of interest from Web2 and, you know, really transitioning into the space. So we're really breaking into the mainstream here. The feedback we've been getting is, you know, more and more games are interested in entering the space and really thinking about how they can use NFTs to be value add for games rather than just, you know, being grindy or a cash grab.
Or the scam mentality that people think it is.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So really exciting to, you know, start to be value add for gamers.
For sure. And just the value add, where do you see this going from here? You know, the power to the players and giving back also to developers, right? Because they can make developers can make money on their games off the secondhand transactions through the blockchain. Where do you see this going for players, the whole space, in the next 5 years?
Yeah, I think some of the most exciting things is funding. We can totally revolutionize game funding, right?
Absolutely.
Like developers can do early drops, they can start to monetize.
Decentralized fundraising.
Absolutely. How exciting. You know,
yeah.
We can really get that into people. And just ownership, right? You know, breaking away from sort of play to earn and grindy games and just truly owning the assets you have, being able to trade them around, being able to build totally different economies,
right.
And just, you know, revolutionizing the space.
I completely agree. Thank you so much for taking the time. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.